Hey guys. Welcome back. We're gonna gear up here for sunflower harvest. And we only have one draper right now, so we're gonna have to go and rent another one soon. Guys, fueled and ready to go. So I'm taking this guy back because he's a pretty bad driver. We have our 2623 working the ground still. He's just got one more field to go and then we'll be done with that. So we got our caravan going. I need to rent another draper at the dealer, so we'll probably stop down there and pick one up. And work our way to field 37. Which I believe is like 90 acres of soybeans. So we should get a couple trucks out of that field. Probably is going to average around 60 bushel an acre, if all goes well. Alfalfa's mowed, ready to merge and bale and sell. I just need to do it. It's kind of curious. Maybe I might even use Xavier's new windrow baler. I think that'd be pretty cool. I feel like Courseplay would be able to use that pretty easily. But that's the last crop of alfalfa on that field, I believe. Actually, we might do one more next season. And then put down some nutrients and primary till it. And here's more beans. So I imagine our soybean harvest will go really quick with two 45 foot drapers. I mean, we only have like 600 or 700 acres planted. maybe 500 or 600 acres planted, and then we had like 600 acres of sunflower and like 200 or 300 acres of corn. So whatever the numbers are, I can't really remember. It's a total of 1,300 acres, though. I think field 20 is 40 or 60 acres of alfalfa. Little hike down here, but not too bad. It's only a 4x map. It's not like it's a 16x map where you have to drive a half hour to your destination. It's big enough where it's kind of inconvenient to drive everywhere, but it's also too small to trailer everything. I typically start down here. Otherwise, I could start in the northwest and go east, which I probably will. Be a little bit easier, I think. So if we load .37, working with on those as well, like 12 or something. I'll have to use the other combine because he has the header to set up a course. Where I'm selling all my bales. They give me good money for my alfalfa bales. So we'll unfold this guy. We already got our CT truck down there. So we'll hold off. Probably move this spout out. Got a different soybean chop straw texture as well. We got our cut to normal. Now we will calculate our 37, 13. Okay, so we'll say it's like say it's like 27 north west. We're going east. Two headlands. Actually, I'm gonna bump this down. Yeah, that's fine. And we'll save that as 37 Drapers. And then we want this guy. What do you want to set this guy? Like 6, 7. 7.3. See how that works. So that guy is good to go. Then we're gonna grab our truck here. Go grab another Draper. Probably rent it for, I don't know, 6 hours. That'd be around 18. Oh, I'll rent it for like 8 hours. Bring us to 20. That guy's doing work with the 26-23. He's got the big section of 44 to do. And I think it's a good call to turn those to alfalfa, and then we'll turn this to like corn or beans or sunflower or something else. So we're on a mission here, 96 miles an hour. Find our Drapers here, headers. I'm going to rent that for. We'll do the 6 hours. I was hoping to have Julian's Mac on Drapers, but he's not even around. He's gone for a couple weeks doing real farming, so just gonna have to settle for these New Hollands. Nothing wrong with them, it's just kinda overusing these all the time. It's day 4, we have 4 days to finish up our harvest and we'll be done by tonight. So I think I might actually put down nutrients and do some primary tillage, because we only lost, you know, it won't take more than 3 days, so. Especially if I run into the night, early morning. These headers transport very well at like 50, 60 miles an hour. I realized that I should only be going like 25. What can you do? Alright, so that guy's done. Come grab our fold that guy up. Just chew up these beans. Nom, nom, nom. shift H. So the computer does the work for us. I'm gonna put this guy's spout out. And we're gonna load 37 Draper. And do 7.1 7. Yeah, I might have screwed up on something. See how that works, otherwise we're gonna have to figure something else out. Carving out a lot of beans. Worst case scenario, I'll just drop the working width down 0.5 meters. But you can see with two of these combines going, it's not going to take very long to chew up these fields. That's one of the benefits of all this Draper work. Might even do Milo this way as well, just because it'll be quicker, even though it's set up for corn headers. It uses the corn fruit shader, so it's in 30-inch rows. I changed the soybean texture so it's a little bit more in, you know, sync for color wise, like color wise. So. Nutrients look pretty good in this field. Neutral pH. got a lot of nitrogen, got a good amount of PK. Soil moisture is not terrible. Probably go find our Kinsey and meet these guys down here by CPS. So you can see it's a pretty large field that we're cutting up here, 90 acres, if my memory serves me right. And then you got field 33. This is such a enormous field. Might actually have to use auto combine if you were to do something like that, so you can suction it. You know, you can cut some strips in the middle, and then they'll turn around once they hit that strip and work their way back. As opposed to course play, which it doesn't really, there's no ability for that course play to recognize a strip. It'll just go right through it. Because I don't really use auto combine, but it's definitely a more intuitive mod for harvesting. It gives you more control over how you want to harvest and like what direction and what kind of method, and if you just want to keep going around and around, or if you want to do rigid forward and backward, or you know, it's a lot more flexibility. And like I said, you can do sections and it will recognize the section that you made. I have a feeling I'm gonna have to fix these combines, because I did something. So it's 27.2. And if I were to do 26.5. That'd be 13. So 6, 7. Let's say that is 37 Draper. 6, 7, that should be good. Then I'll load this guy up again and change this to 6, 7. And that should be a lot better. Thank you. forget that I'm not unloading with a corn header anymore. So that guy's working, this guy's done. That correctly. Go southeast, go north. Should be over here. So that guy is gonna do his tillage and then he'll be done for the day. Got this guy on our mowers. I go find our grain cart. Yeah, 21.8 hours. All 21.8 of those hours has been on the grain cart, so. So when you're doing offsets and you only have two, you split your working width in half, your original working width. So this is 13.6, so you split that in half for your offset. So you have like 6.5, 6.78. Should be your offset, so my check should be 6.8, not 6.7. But we also back down the overall working width a half a meter off, so we're still gonna be fine. Now, if I was running three combines, I would have the full offset, the full original working width. So, like the left would be 13.5 to the left, the middle would have zero offset, and the one on the right would have 13.5 on the right. It's just that when you're running that kind of, because the course play is based on the course of all three combined, so that's when turns get kind of funky and you start missing some crops. Is when you increase the working width so much that it has a hard time making big turns. So what is this guy doing? Oh, I must have started a little off. Anyways, Kinsey's working great, just moving a tremendous amount of grain. might add in a fill plane for soybean too on this map, because right now I think it's like default of barley or wheat or whatever this is. So I'm gonna add a fill plane because I have a fill plane for Milo and sunflower, but I don't have one for soybean or oat or rye. Not that you really need one, but I think it would be nice to have a little bit different fill volume. And it's nice because it's all part of the map, the material holder part. So I'm not in your working with guy. Come on. I mean, that doesn't look that great, the default grain texture, but gotta go find some soybean fill volume textures. So I think this field is big enough that warrants a truck route. It's just that the truck route's gonna have to go to a small bin. which, you know, not the worst thing in the world, but can't really use it again if I wanna truck grain to the big bins, but at least now you guys get to see this area. I don't believe I have very many videos of this area down here with the roads and power lines and houses and trees that I put in, so some old work, pretty old work down here, but and then you can see off in the background like the hotel. Starting to put in some UPK stuff. Like semstone, because there's a semstone in Richmond, Wisconsin, so you can bring sand and gravel and then sell your concrete and cement at construction sites. Like the around town. And then we have the Budweiser plant that makes beer if you bring in barley and stuff. And then right now the only place you can sell that is at the grocery store, but I might bring it, put a sell point at the hotel. But it's just pretty basic stuff right now. There's no like visualization of you being loaded with pallets and kegs of beer and stuff like that. I'm actually gonna drop this. Let me see if I lift the axle and if I drop the axle. So I think what I'll do is I actually will start a course. I like doing grain cart on crops like these just because it's a little bit more relaxed. You're bringing in less material and you're not so stressed out trying to keep up with course play on four different things, you know, two trucks going, two combines going. too bad they don't like back up and go at it at like a 90 degree angle like Auto Combine does. Then you wouldn't have that issue of that residual like miss sweeping turn effect. But oh well. It is a big draper though, 45 feet. Beans for me to take. I don't think we have enough to fill this up. So you can see we're knocking out this field pretty quick. I imagine it won't take more than 5 hours, 5-6 hours to do the rest of our fields. You can see them. You know, most of them are pretty small, and then over there by the farm we have a couple big ones, but everything should, you know, get knocked out super quick, so I'm not really, you know, this section of field 11, field 11 and 12 and 6 and 7, those will take less than an hour, I imagine. Imagine we're going to have some turning issues coming up. Unless that guy gets his butt in gear. Stop! Of course they hit. Of course they hit again. I don't know why it doesn't like have a wider range of like, it's like, oh, vehicle's blocked while it's hitting it, you know, it's like it doesn't, it's not smart enough to recognize like I'm about to hit this, so I should probably stop. It's the only downside of course play, I think, is its collision recognition is not the greatest. Oh, that's good. He has to do that big ass turn, so it separates them a little bit more. Anyways, guys, I'll probably end the video here, so thanks for watching.